These two alternative hypotheses are one-tailed tests. If our sample mean lies out here in the critical region, significantly higher than the current population mean, then we're guessing that the population parameter after the intervention will be greater than the current. Similarly, if our sample mean lies in the critical region below the current population parameter, the population parameter with the intervention will have a lower score than it does currently. And finally, if our sample mean lies in the critical region either higher or lower than the current population parameter, then we conclude that the new population will be significantly different. We choose a one-tailed or directional hypothesis test when we predict a direction of the treatment effect. For example, when we predict that a song illustrating the concepts in this lesson will increase or decrease engagement. Alternatively, we would choose a two-tailed or non-directional hypothesis test when we do not predict a direction of the treatment effect. In general, we use two-tailed tests because they are more conservative. We are less likely to reject the null when it's true. We'll get more into that later. But also because, as you saw before, we might be wrong about the direction. We might predict that the treatment's going to increase engagement, when in fact it decreases engagement, in which case we should have a two-tailed test. If we just used a one-tailed test in the positive direction, we may miss the fact that the treatment is doing the opposite of what we would expect. One exception to this general rule is when we're comparing a new treatment with an established treatment. In such cases, we often only care if the new treatment is better than the old one. We don't care if the new one is much worse. So that's when we would use a one-tailed directional test.